Transport for London is considering plans to stop bus passengers paying for their journeys with cash. It says more than 99% of bus journeys are currently paid for with an Oyster or bank card, and scrapping cash fares would save them £24 million a year. But critics argue the changes are an attack on the poor and could leave passengers stranded. Here's our transport correspondent, Tom Edwards.
How we pay for bus fares is changing. Most use Oyster, more are using bank cards, and now it could be the end of paying using cash.
Tourists don't necessarily get Oyster cards, so they need to have cash anyway.
So you think they should keep cash fares?
They should keep it as an option.
It won't really make a difference because I always use Oyster.
Drunk people, they might forget to top up their Oyster. So, yeah, maybe. I don't think they should get rid of it, to be honest.
What, you think they should keep cash?
Just in case, as a backup.
With a nimbleness and confidence that would do justice to a much older hand...
Cash used to be king and the only way to pay on the buses, but now it's used in just 1% of bus journeys. And collecting it costs TfL £24 million a year. It also slows down boarding. And now contactless bank cards are used by 23,000 passengers a day.
Transport for London's also looking at a feature where passengers get one more journey if they have insufficient funds on their Oyster card. And plans for using contactless bank cards on the tube are actually well advanced. What this all really is probably the beginning of the end of cash fares on London Transport.
There is, though, concern from the mayor's opponents, including the unions. They want TfL to ensure no vulnerable passengers are kicked off buses if cash fares are withdrawn.
Now less than 1% of our passengers are paying cash, and it's getting to the point where it's costing us a lot of money to collect that cash, to bank it, to administer it. And we also believe by taking cash off the bus, we can speed up the journey as well and make those journeys for everybody a little bit faster. So it's getting to the point where so few people are now paying cash. It does make sense to actually consult and ask people's views on whether it's now the right time to take cash away from the London bus network.
The consultation ends in October. Buses could be cashless next year. Tom Edwards, BBC London News, Vauxhall.
Well, Tom is with me now. Tom, is this likely to happen?
I think it is going to happen. The only question is when that's going to happen. If there was a huge outcry, then perhaps the timetable might slip a little bit, but we haven't had that outcry yet.
So what happens next then?
Well, we're in the middle of some really big changes when it comes to ticketing and fares in London. The next thing that we're going to get is contactless bank cards on the tube. You'll be able to use your bank card. And so I think there will be less emphasis on cash and on money. Other cities are looking at London. What happens here often spreads.
OK, thanks very much for that, Tom. Our transport correspondent, Tom Edwards, there. More than